It's a new year, a new decade, and we are ready to renew our push for a higher minimum wage. In order to do that, I was looking for inspiration. As we just passed Reverend Martin Luther King Jr.'s, what would be his 91st birthday, I remembered his legacy and the important events he helped lead. Ms. Rosa Parks came to mind. To me, she could have represented today's minimum wage worker. She was a woman, hardworking, trying to make ends meet, and was just tired. Tired and fed up enough to create one of the most famous civil disobedience in history. With an incredible amount of persistence, tenacity, enduring of battle wounds, and wide community support, the desegregation of public facilities became a reality. Pennsylvania, or rather the House Republicans, are treating minimum wage like a back of the bus issue. It needs to be front and center. I know for a fact that most minimum wage workers are tired and fed up too, working more and working for less. We are not going to allow these workers to sit in the back anymore. We have said in the past, poverty is not a character issue. It's a lack of money issue. People working full-time should be able to sit in the front too and help move our economy to a better place in terms of purchasing power. As I see stakeholders up front and in the audience, you remind me of the activists back in the 60s. You have been persistent and strong, standing in support of in the rotunda or outside a fast food restaurant in the bitter cold. Your efforts are being recognized, and we appreciate your work. I want to end with a quote that my spiritual friends always tell me. Claim it by speaking it into existence. A minimum wage hike will happen this year. It's coming. Just like with Rosa Parks, we are on the right side of history.